right, they are on their way. Nearby the first blue diseased apple. Approaching the first ripe red apple that they want to pick and hold. Again, a blue diseased apple. So they've taken a little bit of a different approach than we've seen from any other competitor so far. They've got a mechanism on their robot where they're knocking the balls off. On the lower row, and then an over-centered pick for the top row. So they've left the green apple on appropriately. From what I'm seeing so far, they're also collecting the diseased apples, the blue apples. We'll see if they maybe discharge those at the end of the run. Some of the previous competitors had issues with their guidance system being able to drive down the rows and get their robots adjacent to the apples. It certainly seems as though this team has got their guidance system figured out. Also, you can see on their mast, there's a camera that rotates from one side to the other. So right now it's pointing towards the row of apples that they're picking. But at the end of the row, when they switch sides, you can see the robot rotate that camera and look to the other side. It's an advantage from a cost perspective of only requiring one sensor instead of two to look at either side of the row. So again, they're doing a great job with leaving the green apples, but it appears as though they're picking both the red ripe apples that they need to or want to be picking and holding, and also holding onto the blue ones. There we go, that was a diseased apple, a blue one that didn't get retained. So as it switches side, again, you can see the camera rotate to the opposite side. So they have 2 minutes left. They're well on their way through the course, over halfway, so they should have lots of time to finish. They're approaching the second last row. It looks to me as though they're using proximity sensors to place the robot right up against the row. One minute left. So there was a couple misfires there, but it did leave the green apple. It's on to the last row. Got 20 seconds left. We're at 7, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1, that's time. Good job, University of Georgia. So that was the UGA Engineer.